Another key? Hello, Nina.
Uncle.
What are you digging for?
Already.
Treasure? How exciting. Well, good luck then. That's very pretty, Nina, but it doesn't look like treasure to me. More like a bottle cap. That's the spirit. A treasure hunter has to handle disappointments. A key? Now that is exciting. What is it, Pocoyo?
Key.
Of course, it's a key. But do you know what it's for?
Yes.
Because I have my theories.
No, I tell. Closer. Closer. Treasure! Treasure!
Pocoyo seems to know all about this. I think he's done it before. Now I remember. It's the key to Treasure Island. Uh-huh. Hello, Ellie. What a nice tea party. Listen, you won't believe what just happened. That's strange.
Treasure!
Watch out, Pato. Something crazy is going on today. Oh, dear.
Treasure!
Really, Pocoyo? I don't think Pato's bath is the right place to... Last time, this took you down to Treasure Island.
Treasure!
It doesn't seem to be going down.
Uh-oh.
This doesn't look like Treasure Island.
No treasure?
Look, treasure! Oh.
There should be a lock here somewhere, shouldn't there? What if you close your eyes and think of something very important to you? Your very own treasure.
Treasure, 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 treasure!
There! You did it! I think this is Treasure Island.
Treasure!
What could be inside? Oh, it's so exciting. Friends? Pirate friends? Arrgh, shiver me timbers! You've been piratified! What fine pirates! And what good friends! Now that really is a wonderful treasure. Goodbye. See you next time.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Hi, Ellie. Hola, Pato. What's that sound? Oh, I see. Pato has set his alarm. That's odd. Packing? Where are you off to, Pato? You're going to visit your friends, Fred and Whale, underwater. What fun! Good idea. You'll need those where you're going. You're wondering what Pato is up to, right? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Ellie where Pato is going?
To visit
Whale
and Octopus.
He's going underwater.
Bye, Pato. Have fun. Playing with friends underwater. What could be more fun? What's this? A ball. Great. You're going to play catch. Ow. It's hard to play catch underwater. Oh my, all of your toys are floating away. What are you going to play with? Ah, your trumpet. Now this should be fun. Oh dear. Apparently, trumpets and water don't mix. Ah, now here's something you can enjoy, a comic book. Oh dear, it's ruined. Pato? Dear, being underwater even puts a damper on your tantrum. I'm afraid Pato isn't having as much fun as he expected to. Ah, nothing like a nice meal to cheer you up, right, Pato? Woohoo! That certainly is an interesting dish. Seaweed spaghetti, is it? Pato wants to know if you'd like to eat some. No, me? No. Oh, no, no, no. I ate earlier. I think you'll have to tuck in, Pato. Good work, Pato. Oh, dear. You're not leaving, are you, Pato? Is it because none of your toys worked? And you don't like the food here? I suppose you're missing home. Looks like Whale is going to give you a ride before you leave. Just to show you how much fun being underwater can be. Wow! Whee! This is kind of fun, isn't it? There's something else Whale would like to show you before you go, Pato. A bubble. Look at that. You can play ball in there, just like at home. This? Sponges. A sponge trampoline. What fun! It looks as if Pato is having a really great time. What do you think? Does Pato like it underwater after all? What's this? A giant shell? What's inside?
Hey!
It's Pocoyo and Ellie! Hooray for getting used to new things! And hooray for fishy friends! Bye-bye! See you soon! Hello, Pocoyo. What are you doing? Oh, of course! We'll wait. Oh, you've made a card, and a very nice one, too. Do any of you know what it's a picture of?
Oh.
Is that card for Whale? Wait, is it Whale's birthday today? Is Whale having a birthday party? Ellie, are you taking a gift to Whale's birthday party? A balloon? But how do you wrap it up? Great work, Pocoyo! I wonder if Whale will be able to guess what it is.
Pato!
Let's see what Pato is making for Whale. What a wonderful cupcake, Pato! Well, Whale is going to love her gifts.
To Whale!
Oh dear! That sounded like a balloon popping. Oh dear. Well, at least we still have the card and the cupcake.
Mm-hmm.
What a lovely fish. Pato, I think you've lost something. Your cake. Something tells me that fish gobbled it. At least you still have Pocoyo's wonderful card. Yes, there's whale.
Happy birthday, whale.
It's been quite a trip, whale. And everyone made lovely gifts for you. Ellie was going to give you a wonderful balloon. But unfortunately, it popped along the way. And Pato made you a beautiful cupcake. But unfortunately, a little fish ate it up. Luckily, there's still another gift. Pocoyo made you a wonderful birthday card. Oh no! The water spoiled the lovely card Pocoyo made. Oh dear! No balloon, no cake, and no card. Look, Whale is happy, even if you haven't brought a card or a cake or a balloon. Can any of you tell Pocoyo, Pato and Ellie what, or rather who, they have brought to Whale's party?
They brought themselves!
Yes! Pocoyo, Pato and Ellie are here! Hooray for the best gift of all! Friends! And hooray for Pocoyo! See you soon! Bye-bye!
Bye-bye!
Holidays. Hello, Pocoyo. It's good to see you. Where have you been these past weeks? Oh, I see. You've been on holidays. I bet you can't wait to tell your friends all about it. And here's Pato, also back from holidays too. How nice. You and Pocoyo will have plenty to talk about. And so will you, Ellie. Holidays are over for everyone. Time for a reunion. Home at last. Well, it's good to be together again. Ah, Ellie. Very nice. And Sleepy Bird, too. Well, now. Let's hear what you each did on your holidays. Who wants to start? Pato, perhaps? Oh, a trip to the beach. And you built a sandcastle there. Then you went fishing. What's that? The fish was bigger than that? Still not big enough? Now? Ah, you had some fun in the snow, Ellie. Let's hear all about it. You met some new friends. And you built a big snowman together. My, that is big. And you practiced jumps with your snowboard. How cool is that? What's that? The jump was higher? This high? You jumped so far, you even had time to read and do some yoga and even have a tea party. Why, that's unbelievable. And it looks like Pocoyo and Pato might agree with me. Okay, okay, Ellie. Let's hear your story, Pocoyo. You went flying to outer space. You flew past some amazing planets. A lettuce planet? Sounds very healthy. And a strawberry planet? Delicious. Until you got to a planet made of cake and giant candy? Are you quite sure, Pocoyo?
Yes, Jim.
You seem to have had a lot of fun there, Pocoyo. And then you ate the whole planet?
Yes!
Well, did that really happen? I'm not sure the others buy your tale, Pocoyo. What about your holidays, sleepy bird? What did you do? That just might be the most wonderful holidays of all of them.
Mine best.
Hold on now. Must you all argue about your holidays? After all, it's fun to share our holiday stories with our friends. Even if maybe some parts of the stories aren't exactly how things happened.
No!
Come on now, Pocoyo. And really, the best part is that you're all here having fun together again. Off you go. Time for play.
Let's play!
And no more tall tales.
Bye.
Good. Bye-bye now.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello!
Ooh, what are you doing? Oh, that's wonderful, Pocoyo. Can any of you tell what Pocoyo is drawing?
It's a fish!
A picture of a fish!
Exactly, it's a fish. A green fish. And what a beautiful green fish it is. What are you thinking about now, Pocoyo?
More picture!
Oh, I know. How about a nice place for the fish to live? Hi, Pato. Have you seen what Pocoyo's drawing? What's wrong, Pato? Look at that! Can any of you see where that fish is?
It's in the sky!
Yes, it's a fish in the sky! How imaginative, Pocoyo! I don't think Pato has seen a fish that lives in the sky before. It must be a birdfish, a bish, or a fish bird, or a furred. Oh, never mind. What are you going to draw next, Pocoyo? A lovely blue fish. That's really very nice, Pocoyo. Now, I wonder who that could be. I think Pocoyo wants to surprise you, Ellie.
Ta-da!
Look at that! Can any of you see where this fish lives?
In the trees!
Well, that's wonderfully imaginative too, Pocoyo. Look at that fish go! It's quite the swinger, isn't it? Oh dear, I don't think Ellie has seen a fish that lives in the forest before.
Another picture.
You're going to draw another picture, Pocoyo? I wonder what it's going to be this time. This is really fun. Oh, what a fantastic red fish. Well, I wonder where the red fish will live. Look at that! Can any of you see where this lovely red fish lives?
In the sea!
Yes, it's under the water in the sea. Oh yes, I suppose that drawing does show where fish really live. Wow! My goodness! Oh, I think Pocoyo is trying to tell you that he made those pictures for you, Pato and Ellie. I suppose it just goes to show it's lots of fun when you use your imagination. What's this? A gift for all of us? Why, thank you, Pocoyo. It's lovely. Hooray for Pocoyo and his lovely pictures. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Oh, my. A pirate flag? our friends seem different. They have a telescope. Pocoyo has an eye patch.
A map!
And they have a map. Oh, I see. They're pirates.
Treasure chest!
They're pirates looking for a treasure chest. Oh, they're piranhas. Be careful, Pirate Pocoyo. Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story.
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, there was a dinosaur who wanted to go to an island. He took a ship. But then, the ship started to sink. So he took a boat. But then the boat started to sink. So he started to swim. When he got to the island, he phoned his friend, the ant. He asked the ant to come to the island too. So the ant took a ship. But the ship started to sink. So the ant took a boat. But the boat started to sink. So the ant started to swim. When the ant got to the island, they made a lovely sandcastle and had lots of fun. The end. Our pirates are still looking for the treasure. I think Pato sees something. Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato saw?
The treasure chest!
He saw the treasure chest!
Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato used to see the treasure chest? What do you see, Pocoyo?
Treasure chest!
What is that?
Monster!
The treasure chest is guarded by a monster. How will our pirates ever get the treasure?
Wheel of Colors! Welcome to the show! Today's color is orange. Everyone, look for something orange. Something orange. What can you find? All right, let's see your pictures. An orange tent. An orange flag. An orange block. Good. Keep searching for orange things. A carrot. Yes, it's orange. An orange key. Excellent. And this, do you know what it is? An orange alien. Very good. Hooray for orange. Hooray! The pirates have landed. Oh, the piranhas are coming too. Uh-oh. Oh no! The monster is awake! Run, Pocoyo, run! And the piranhas! Run, Pato, run! Oh dear! Phew! Now open the treasure chest! Oh! Can you tell me what that is? another treasure hunt. Ahoy, Pocoyo!
We are the quaint little pirates. We have a map and a telescope. We are the quaint little pirates. We're sailing the sea with our pirate flag. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. We have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. Looking through that telescope.
Treasure chest! Telescope! Map! Ship! Boat!
We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. We have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. Looking through that telescope.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pa... Sorry. Hello. What are you doing in that boat?
Fish.
Ah, I see. You're fishing.
Net.
You have a fishing net and a fishing rod. And Caterpillar is going to help. Wonderful. Now we just have to wait.
Professor Otto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says, this is a ship. A ship. This is a boat. A boat. And this is a lighthouse. A lighthouse. Baby bird, can you tell us what that is? Can you tell baby bird what that is?
It's a lighthouse!
Hmm, it looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Lighthouse!
Wonderful, now we know about ships, boats and lighthouses. Thank you, Professor Pato!
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
Can you tell Caterpillar what that is?
Fish! It's a fish!
That's right, it's a fish. Can you tell the fish what that is? Can you tell the fish what that is?
A fishing rod!
It's a fishing rod!
Look, boys! Pato's got something!
Pato, Pato! Fish!
A boot?
Fish, Pato, fish!
A wheel? Fishing can be very hard. Number menu.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Ah, time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 10 strawberries. Very good.
10 strawberries.
Oh dear. Well, how about 10 peas instead?
10 peas.
10 peas. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
10 hearts!
That's right, 10. Oh dear, you're not catching many fish. Oh, it's a big one! A very big one! Now, Pato and Pocoyo, you're not really angry, are you? After all, it was pretty funny. Hooray for fishing! And hooray for new friends!
I'm in a boat, I am fishing with my fishing rod. To catch a fish, I am using my net. Fishing with my fishing rod. To catch a fish, I am using my net.
Are we there yet? Hello, Ellie. Off to the beach, are you? Ah, just a quiet day by yourself. That sounds very relaxing. Why, look, there's Pato. Ellie, I think Pato wants to go with you. What's that, Pato? You wouldn't mind driving? That's very nice of you. What do you think, Ellie? Pato. Ellie was hoping for a relaxing day today. Ah, yes, much better. More friends, Ellie.
Thank you.
One more couldn't hurt, right, Ellie? And off we go, all together. What's the matter, Nina? Oh, of course. Pato, you'd better stop the car. You too, Pocoyo. Oh, great. Just what we needed. Which way to the beach?
Look at that. Up there.
Ah, very good, Ellie. Maybe he can tell us how to get there. Back at the same place again. Oh no, not again. Fun begin. Well, Ellie, there's nothing like sharing this marvelous sunset with your friends, is there? Even if it was a little hard to get to the beach. Goodbye, everyone. Hello, Pato. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Oh, the postman. And he's got a postcard. I wonder who it's from. It's Ellie. She's at the beach. What fun. It would be nice to go to the beach.
I make.
You'll make a beach, Pocoyo? Well, you'll need a spade.
Spade.
A bucket.
Bucket.
Sunglasses.
Sunglasses.
And a sandcastle.
Sandcastle.
Okay, let's make a beach.
Professor Otto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says...
This is a beach. And this is the sun. The sun. At the beach, you use an umbrella to block the sun. It's very nice under the umbrella. Baby Bird, it's your turn. Can you tell Baby Bird what that is?
Umbrella!
It's an umbrella.
It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Umbrella!
Wonderful! Now we've all learned about the beach. Thank you, Professor Pato. Lesson approved by Professor Pato. Ah, it looks like you two are ready for the beach. Can you tell me what that is?
A spade!
That's right, a spade. And what's this?
It's a bucket!
Right, it's a bucket. But that's not all you need, boys. Can you tell me what those are?
Sunglasses!
Fantastic! You're ready for the beach. The postman again. Ah, another postcard. Ellie has a very big sandcastle. How are you going to make a sandcastle?
I find.
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
A monkey!
A monkey!
Monkey!
A monkey! Right! Ah, you found some sand! And what a beautiful sand castle!
Sand castle!
Ellie's back! Can you tell Ellie what Pocoyo and Pato did? This? Shells! Seashells! Wonderful! So long! See you soon!
Let's go to the beach. Let's play in the sun with our sunglasses on. Let's open the umbrella and play with the spade and the bucket. Let's make a sandcastle, yeah.
Beach! Sunglasses! Umbrella! Spade! Bucket!
Let's go to the beach, let's play in the sun with our sunglasses on. Let's open the umbrella and play with the spade and the bucket, yeah.
Muckstruck. Hello, Ellie. making a nice cup of tea? Oh, dear. That won't do. Good morning, Pocoyo. Ah, bath time. Aren't you forgetting something? Yuck! Your water's gone bad too. Hello, Pato. Oh, do be careful. Your water has a rather icky color, too. Pato? Something must be done about this nasty water straight away. Very good. You should follow the water pipe to the start. The water in this pond simply must be cleaned up. That poor fish. Oh, we should help him. Very good, Pocoyo. You certainly are collecting lots of rubbish. Wonderful, Pato. This pond will be clean in no time. Everyone. But I'm afraid the water is still brown. Uh-uh. Well done, every one of you. Well done indeed. Ah, what a perfect morning on the nice, clean pond. And it's all thanks to all your hard work, guys. Space Holidays. Look, it's Ellie. Hello, Ellie. Where are you going with that big backpack? Oh, you're going on vacation. That's wonderful. Now, now. What seems to be the problem?
Mountain.
Oh, I see. Pocoyo wants to go on vacation to the mountains. Ah, I understand. It seems like Pato would rather go to the beach. Well, they're both fantastic options. We'll have a great time wherever we go. You'll see. Just a moment. I think Ellie has an idea. Space vacation? That sounds like fun, doesn't it? Doesn't it? I'm not sure that Pocoyo and Pato like your idea very much, Ellie. Come on, you two. Trust Ellie. She knows all the best spots in the universe. First stop, the planet of the bubble craters. How exciting! Wow! Ellie, this place is incredible! Oh dear, Pato doesn't seem to like this planet.
Boring.
Oh no, not again. You're right, Ellie. I'm sure they'll like the next planet we visit more than this one. Welcome to the planet of the musical trees. Whoa! What rhythm, Ellie? I don't think Pocoyo is in the mood for dancing. Good idea, Ellie. Let's show them that this planet is amazing. Oh, ah, oh. Oh, dear. Poor Ellie. This isn't turning out to be the most relaxing vacation. last stop, everyone. It's incredible! Look! A beach in space!
Look!
Wow! And that looks like a mountain! It's the best planet in outer space! It has everything! The beach and the mountain! Ellie, this is a wonderful place!
Thank you, Ellie!
Wonderful! Now, everyone is going to enjoy their vacation. Ah, this is the life. Fantastic! Hooray for vacation and hooray for friends! Goodbye, see you soon!
Hey, there's Lula. Hello, Lula. Oh, I wonder what she's looking at. She's very excited, isn't she?
Oh, look, a bubble.
That's what Lula was waiting for. Careful, Lula, you might burst it. Dear, bubbles are really easy to burst, Lula. It's above you, Lula. Quick! You know, where there are bubbles, there has to be someone making bubbles. Do any of you know who's making those bubbles?
Pocoyo!
Oh, yes. Look, it's Pocoyo. And Ellie, too. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Hi.
So it was you making the bubbles.
Bubbles.
Can you show us how, Pocoyo? Right, so you put the wand into the bubble juice, then blow it to make the bubbles. That's great!
Bubbles!
Ellie wants a go at making bubbles now. Oh, aren't bubbles fabulous? Well done, Ellie.
Bubble.
Ha ha! Look at that. Oh, now, just a minute, you two. Oh, dear. But we were all having such fun. Huh.
look at poor Lula. She still wants to play with bubbles. Oh, can't you make some bubbles for Lula, Pocoyo?
No bubbles.
Well, what about you, Ellie? Just one bubble for Lula. I think Lula misses the bubbles. It's too bad there aren't any more bubbles, isn't it? It's no use. Pocoyo can't make Lula any bubbles. And neither can Ellie. Now, let's see. Pocoyo can't make bubbles without the bubble juice. And Ellie can't make bubbles without the wand. Can any of you help Pocoyo and Ellie work out how to make more bubbles?
Share.
Now that's a great idea. Now that's more like it.
Bubbles.
Good for you, Pocoyo and Ellie. You're sharing and making bubbles for Lula together. It seems it's even more fun to play with friends when you share. Just ask Lula. Hooray for Pocoyo and for Ellie and for Lula. Bye. See you soon.
Hello, Lula. Oh, dear. You're getting very dirty. You know what happens when you get dirty, don't you? That's right. It's time for a bath. Come on. Get in the bathtub, Lula. Oh, no. Lula, come back. It's just a bath. It won't hurt you. Ah, Ellie. Thank you. What's that, Pocoyo?
Soap.
Soap. Wonderful. And what's that, Ellie? A brush. Great. Very soon, Lula will be nice and clean. Hi, Ellie.
Ellie. Search, Ellie.
Pocoyo wants you to search for a word on your computer.
Clean.
Pocoyo wants to see something clean. Ah, it's Fred. Oh, my. Are Fred's teeth clean? I think we'd all like to see Fred clean those teeth. Ah, much better. It feels great to have clean teeth.
Thank you, Ellie.
Yes, thank you, Ellie. Well done. There. Lula is nice and clean.
Ha ha ha!
Oh, dear. Here we go again. Can you tell Pocoyo what Ellie wants?
The soap, the brush, the soap and the brush. Soap, brush.
Shape shuffle. A square.
Square.
A circle.
Circle.
A rectangle.
Rectangle.
Square, circle, rectangle. Ooh, what's this, Pocoyo?
MP3.
An MP3 music player. And you've made it with circles, squares, and rectangles. Oh, a speaker. Can you tell me the names of the shapes?
Rectangles.
And these?
Squares.
And these?
Circles.
Square, circle, rectangle. Now Lula is really clean. Doesn't that feel nice, Lula? Uh-oh. This doesn't look good. Ah, good work. But it looks like someone else is dirty now. Yes, you, Pocoyo. Pocoyo, it's just a bath. It won't hurt you.
Pocoyo?
Hi.
What's this? You know what? That looks like a very big seed. You know what you do with a seed, don't you, Pocoyo? What do all of you think? Is that what you do with a seed? Wear it on your head? Put it in your drink. Is that right?
No,
you don't put it there.
Do you plant it?
Yes, you plant it.
That's right. I'm sure that before long something very beautiful will grow from that seed. does seem to be taking its time, doesn't it? Well, growing can take a while, you know. What's that, Pocoyo? Is something the matter? Oh, I see you need the loo. Well, we'll keep an eye on the seed for you. Hurry! Hello, sleepy bird. It's a lovely seed, isn't it? Wait! But what are you doing? Feeling better now, Pocoyo? Good, because there's something I need to tell you. It's about your seed. It's all right, Pocoyo. Sleepy Bird just fancied a snack. Everything's fine now. Oh, look, here's Lula. Hello, Lula. Oh no! Pocoyo, wake up! Wake up! Oh dear! Maybe if you shout with me, we can wake Pocoyo. Ready?
Wake up, Pocoyo!
Wake up! Oh, I see. Lula just wanted to play. Well, that should certainly keep your seed safe, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato. Oh, Pato, I know that looks like an egg, but really it's... Oh, dear. What's this? Well, I'd say your seed is going to be safe now, Pocoyo. No one could possibly get it. Oh, I see. How lovely. Hello, Ellie. Watch out! This isn't good. Oh, Pocoyo, Ellie didn't mean to crush your flower. And now she's stuck in your trap. Lula! It looks like more seeds. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what will grow from all the seeds?
Flowers!
Lots of flowers!
That's right! Lots and lots of flowers! Enough for everyone! For Pocoyo. Oh, and of course, hooray for friends. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Oh, look. It's Pato. Hello, Pato. What have you got there? Soap, a brush, and a towel. What are you going to do with that? Oh, you're going to have a shower? Lovely. Oh, dear. What's this? Pato's soap, brush, and towel are gone. How is he going to have a shower now? A quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. A shower cap?
Shower cap!
A doll? Oh.
Doll!
A phone.
Phone. Bye.
Phone!
Oh dear. Good night. Does anyone see Pato's soap?
There it is!
There's the soap!
Good job! You found it! Does anyone see Pato's brush?
Ellie has it!
She has the brush!
What is that on the scooter?
It's the towel! The towel!
The towel!
Oh dear, Pato is really angry that you took his things. And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, skip. That's it, skip. Fred says, clap hands. Come on, let's clap. That's it, clap. Fred says, spin! Spin! Well done! Fred says, that's all! Oh no, Pato's brush and soap. Pato, your soap is right here. Pato's ready for his brush. And ready for his towel. for showers. And hooray for towels.
I take a shower, wearing my shower cap. I use the soap and then the brush. I take a shower, wearing my shower cap. I use the soap and then the brush. And when I finish, I use the towel. And when I finish, then the phone rings.
I use the towel.
Then the phone rings.